Ready? Right now?
Right now.
Okay.
You're on.
Okay, where are we?
We are in the engine room.
In our engine room. So check this out. There is a lot of space in our engine room at the moment.
Don't be fooled, because the space will be all gone.
Exactly. So we wanted to take the opportunity to show you guys where what equipment is going. We just had a quick walkthrough yesterday. I don't remember everything 100%, but I'm trying to do my best to actually let you guys know.
But let's first explain that this looks huge, because some people were saying, hey, you guys, the patrons that I've seen now and the members have seen the, okay, careful please, still need you alive. Yes, that it looks really, really big right now. It looks huge, right?
But we will have a lot of equipment.
It's not gonna look like this. It's actually gonna be kind of cramped in the way with how much equipment we've got.
So let's start with the obvious. Main engines sitting in these cavities here, a little bit lower, so they're coming up roughly to about here.
Oh, that much?
Yeah.
Oh, cool, okay.
And the other one, of course, here on the port side. Our floor will sit roughly here. Engine room floor. Obviously, here's a cutout because the engine comes out. On top of this here, there will be our air conditioning units.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, air conditioning, the chiller's gonna sit right there. Above that, we will have our control modules for engines and generators. Okay, then now moving over here, up here on top, we will have both of our water makers right there. Actually, really good access, because the floor will be roughly, like I said, on this level. So you're actually standing perfectly fine to reach your water makers. One of the generators, other one over there, same shelf. Exactly. Next here will be, what was it, exhaust. The exhaust mixing and what's it called? Exhaust mufflers. The mufflers. There's some pumps here underneath. I forgot what there were. And then here in the back, we will have our power switchboard. So all electrical switchboard will sit here on the back wall.
All I heard yesterday is pumps, 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 pumps. Was sounded pumps, like pumps, we pumps, have pumps, like pumps, 40 pumps.
So
have to be careful. Look, you guys, we're walking sitting, on this here.
We have pumps sitting up on top here. That's for the water maker. And the air conditioned pumps sit underneath, or vice versa. Don't exactly remember anymore.
So the floor is literally right there, right?
The floor I think, should be roughly somewhere here.
No, it's higher than that. It's there. Maybe here.
Hydraulic pack will be sitting right here.
Oh, okay.
So the big hydraulic unit.
Oh, that's got like a prime spot.
I forgot what's sitting up. Hey, you know what? Wasn't the air conditioner sitting up there, the chiller units?
That's what I thought.
Yeah, air conditioner is sitting up there. Both of the, one chiller in each spot. Then we have over here on the starboard side, the black and gray water treatment plant, headhunter, sitting right here.
Oh, okay.
Like I said, the generator sitting right here. I think it's the same like over there. It will be the mufflers and mixing units for the exhausts. And then something, oh yeah, up here were the fuel transfer pump and the fuel polishing system will be sitting up there. I think that was it in the engine room. So then if you look over here, all the way up on top there, we already see the hydraulic lines coming through, which are going all the way forward to the windlass, both windlass, to the bow thruster.
Well, you guys saw them in the VIP.
Yes, yes. So how many lines do we have here? One, two, three. So yeah, that's windlass and bow thruster. There must be some more hydraulic, that's probably some of these which are taped off already over there, which are gonna go to the midship fins, stabilizing fins, because we have four fins, right? We have one here, one there in the engine room. These are our aft fins. And then we have two fins midship. So it's altogether four fins. These are down here, our salt water, seawater, sea chests. So we have two big tubes with a cap on top, and from there everything goes up.
How do you clean them? How do you get them out?
You can open them up.
Yeah?
You can clean them from the bottom, actually, from underneath. You can go in because they're permanently open.
Oh,
they're always open.
But how do you, really? So you don't,
you only open them up when you haul the boat out.
Oh, you never open?
No, this you never open.
So if they look really,
you have valves here.
If you have, if they look, I don't understand. So if they look, you know, it's like, oh, let's go check the sea chest, and then you look at it and it's bad, you have to go dive? You cannot clean it from the top?
Yeah, and I cannot see them from the top anyways because they're closed off with a metal plate.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
So we have two valves here, we can shut them off, and then we have a big manifold which has all the valves on there for generators, air conditioning, main engines, so everything which takes seawater goes, gets fed by these two sea chests.
Okay.
Yeah. So there will be here a big manifold here. Obviously you can open the floor and have all your valves here. Oh, another thing what we have underneath here, there we have the units, the brains for the main engine song. Here will be a huge, our main fuel manifold. So all the valves here, where we can transfer fuel from one tank to another and so on. These are, this will be our manifold here, our fuel manifold. What else? Did I forget anything?
Probably.
Engine room ventilation.
Oh, the round thing.
Yep,
there's
one over there,
right?
And one over there.
Uh-huh. That's access from inside of the boat.
So yeah, this is actually kind of like the space below the staircase, which goes to the flybridge, almost like a little corridor. One door goes to the side deck outside, the other door goes to the salon.
Uh-huh.
What else? Should we go over to the lazarette?
Crazy, looks crazy. Okay, wait, I had a question. Hold
yes.
on. I had a question. It was, oh, so all of this underneath, like it's all like pipes, the rest of the space?
A lot of areas will be filled with pipes, yeah.
Pipes, yeah. Okay. All right.
Of course, our main engines. And,
and this right here.
I mean, look how tall this is. I'm 5'7". No, that's you.
He's 5'10". Or something. Are you 5'10"?
I'm 5'10", yeah.
But I mean, it's not much bigger.
It is a full-blown two-story engine.
And that is how they're going to get the engines inside of this space. This
you
is
mean
a soft patch.
The soft patch?
They're going to remove that and crane them in here. And they're going to go right in this spot here.
All the big equipment is going to get craned in.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So then, Lazarette. I think I already forgot what where things are going in the lazarette.
Really?
No, some stuff I know. Some stuff
Come
I know.
Come on, man. Okay, wait. Okay. You want to go in there?
I go up.
And then you can be down here, whatever you want to be.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Remember, you guys, it's unedited and raw. There
unedited and raw. Exactly.
All right.
Okay. Everything here on the starboard side, at least for now, until we change things, but for now, everything here will be electric. Batteries as well as inverter chargers. So most of our Victron equipment will be here on the wall. Our batteries will be here and potentially spread out also on this side.
So is this battery space air conditioned?
Yes. Both of the spaces. So we have a self-contained air conditioning unit in this space. It's going to sit up there. Yep. And then we have also a self-contained unit sitting, I think it was somewhere here up on top as well.
Okay.
Or on the other side. I don't remember. Then we have a hydraulic pump over there for the steering. We have a hydraulic pump over there for the transformer. The open power transformer.
No, my question was not if the lazarette is air conditioned, if the actual spaces for batteries have like a It's like a shelf that's AC?
Well, it's a shelf and will have a ventilation as well because the space is air conditioned.
Okay.
So that should be sufficient.
Even if this door is open?
Well, we don't want to leave the door permanently. I mean, look, if it's really, really hot outside, we're going to close the door in between. We don't need to open.
Oh, okay. I thought you guys are putting AC into the shelving unit.
We're going to run one vent into the shelving
unit. So there is. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah. I forgot what else was in here. There was some
something
other,
in the lower part.
Yes, over there there is
the
cable reel.
Yeah, the glendanic. Yeah.
And then we also have the fire emergency pump there.
Oh, it's there.
Yes.
Okay.
And that's the diesel fire emergency pump, actually.
The what?
The diesel fire
emergency
pump. Yeah.
Okay.
We will add storage up here, right? Hanging stuff up on the top.
Like this spot space is here, because it's not going to be, again, the height of this is going to be a lot taller, so we will not have, this is going to be covered by the height. It's not going to be this tall, you guys.
Yeah.
What?
Nothing.
What?
I think that's it.
You don't remember what else?
No, I don't remember anything else. I got to look on the computer.
Okay, well, hey. You guys are the first to see it. No one said it's going to be perfect. So this is why we're going to do another one that's going to be edited and it's going to have maybe a bit more detail. But at least you get an idea and you get to see it twice with a little more explanation later.
Exactly. So what I think we're going to do is I'm going to look at the computer one more time on the 3D drawings and maybe take some sticky notes and put it on the places where things are going. And if something.
Don't they have writing there or is it in Turkish?
No, nothing.
There's all writing everywhere, but I think only the person who wrote it knows what it is.
Exactly, I don't know.
Because it is marked, you can see it right there,
it's all
marked. But you don't know what it is, because you don't know who marked it.
You don't know what it is?
You don't know what it is? Okay!
Well, thank you guys, thanks for watching. This was a very improvised little tour of our engine room and of our lazarette. And, what?
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!